Alhaji Jallo, country representative, Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations, stressed that FAO is committed towards supporting agriculture sector in Uganda, particularly among the youth who are currently suffering from unemployment.
This strategy, as I said, will specifically provide a policy framework to address issues pertaining to youth employment in the agriculture sector. On this note, I would like to commend the government of Uganda for its current efforts to create a school environment that empowers children, their families, and the school community to make good food choices and develop lifelong healthy eating habits that can lead to lasting improvements in health and nutrition well-being. For young people who continue to look at agriculture as a job for the uneducated people, we at FAO believe that supporting young people who appreciate agriculture as a business and means of livelihood is a worthy cause that we will continue to support as we work with government to improve livelihoods and end hunger and malnutrition.
Chate Kamondo, Assistant Commissioner, Public Relations Officer, Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, who doubles as Youth Development Global Specialist, says that most of the funding from the government to community initiatives is focusing on the youth to reduce on unemployment.
What we need to concentrate on is the mindset change, where some people look at agriculture as a dirty job. And I was telling them, how can agriculture be a dirty job, since we all live because of the products that come out of the soil? If we use these young people to change the mindset of other people, this will not be the first time we are doing it.
Some of the students from various schools across the country applauded the agriculture camp that has changed their mindset on agriculture, because before then they didn't know that this sector is beneficial, and they stressed that they will immediately start practicing agriculture as part of implementing what they have acquired.
Being able to learn how to plant platoke, groundnuts and other stuff. There are some times when I didn't know how to plant some of them, but now I've learned. So when I grow up, I'll be able to plant something so that I get income.
At agriculture, as I mean, something sort of a by the way. I mean, I don't know, there are so many nice things in agriculture. It looked very boring to me. Though, yeah, some people get a lot of money from it, it looked boring to me, but I've gained the interest in agriculture. I realized that it can be fun. For example, forestry, the trees, those trees are amazing. You can plant a whole big area of trees and it looks so serene. And flowers, especially flowers and trees. And then use of machinery. Personally, I'm interested in technology.
You ignore agriculture, you're ignoring your life. Why? If the gentleman is able to survive on the watermelon only, now what if he plants as much as, what if he involves himself in other projects like the mushroom? By the way, the mushroom is very, very, very productive. We harvest them twice a day.
Samuel Otim Rizzo, chief of Party Sky Project, AVSI Foundation, adds that this agriculture camp is a success. Therefore, the young people have been inspired by the farming practices and appreciated all partners who have been behind this initiative.
It's been a big, big success. So thank you, everybody, for organizing it. And the participation also from the private sector. One of our strategies is to involve the private sector, the agribusinesses, into skilling. That's why we told Victoria, when we started organizing the camp, that we could not delink farming from the actual agribusinesses or the actual farms outside there. That's why we involved some of those farmers. We wanted also to give the opportunity to the youth to see champions, to see people who outside there is actually doing the real work and are earning a lot of money through it. We should want it to be an inspiration for you, but also an inspiration for us.
It is upon anyone to give a benefit of doubt to agriculture sector amidst efforts geared towards commercializing, though its funding is still very low. This story was compiled by Eric Wakabi, WBS, Kampala.